नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई एम जेवियंस डॉक्टर नीरज धोलिया, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक प्रोडक्ट आइसोलेशन एक्सट्रैक्शन एंड एडसॉर्प्शन मेथड। एंड दिस टॉपिक इज कम्स अंडर द सब्जेक्ट अपस्ट्रीम डाउनस्ट्रीम प्रोसेस। So in the previous lectures, we have already discussed about the product isolation steps, how what are the various methods of the product isolation and extraction, like the chromatography and other techniques. In this lecture, we will specifically talk about the adsorption method. So let's start. So the adsorption method is generally comes under the wastewater purification technique. In the wastewater purification technique, for removing a wide range of compounds from the industrial wastewater. Okay, so the adsorption is most commonly implemented for the removal of low concentrations of non-degradable organic compounds from the groundwater, drinking water preparations, process water as tertiary cleansing after, for example, the biological water purification. So most oftenly for the water purification, this adsorption method is used, and the impurity is generally at the low concentration and the non-degradable organic compounds. So here the adsorbents have a very high internal surface area that permits the adsorption. So adsorption needs a material which have the porosity and very high internal area, and the area required to adsorb the impurities. For example, the active carbon. So active carbon is suited to the removal of the apolar compounds. Apolar means, you can say that apolar is non-charge materials. Okay, so the other adsorbents are used for specific applications. For various applications, various adsorbents are required, like the natural or synthetic zeolites. Natural or synthetic zeolites, for example, the alumina silicate polymers. So it have a very homogeneous pore distribution and polar bonding sites. So this adsorbent is known for its very homogeneous distribution of pores. And the silica gel and activated aluminium, very polar adsorbents with large affinity for water, and normally used to remove water from an apolar medium. Okay, so if you have an apolar medium and the water is present there, you want to remove the water from that apolar medium, you can use the silica gel and activated aluminium. So active carbon can be made from wood, charcoal and coconut. So these are the sources from which you can make the active carbon. Each type is characterized by a specific surface, grain size and pore diameter. So active carbon can be used in powder form and granular form, or in the impregnated form. So various types of forms are available of the active carbon. You can use accordingly. So in the powder form, the active carbon is added to the aerobic and anaerobic wastewater purification system, or is added to psychochemical wastewater purification process. So in this case, the added active carbon is removed and treated together with the produced sludge. So active carbon can be chemically impregnated to improve its activity. Okay, so the natural active carbon can be charged. So impregnated carbon was specifically developed to capture the chemical substances and that are normally difficult to absorb with the standard activated carbon. So impregnation can be done using the K2CO3, H2SO4 and sulfur. For the removal of organic sulfides, ammonia and the amines. So these impurities can be removed from this. And absorption installation with adsorbents other than activated carbon normally contains two columns which also become saturated in time. So you need to remove or take the fresh adsorbents or clean the adsorbents. So zeolites and adsorbents that absorb inorganic matter are regenerated using the chemicals. They are regenerated, they are renewed, they are clean. For example, with the using the NaCl solutions. Okay. So specific advantage and the disadvantage of the active carbon. So the active carbon adsorption is a proven and much used technique because of the low energy and the maintenance cost, the simplicity and the reliability. So it is very widely used in various laboratories and other purposes. So an active carbon column requires a limited amount of supervision and the maintenance. A medium knowledgeable person can use it. No much experience is required for using this, and there is less experience was absorption using other adsorbents than there is for active carbon adsorption. So the effectiveness of the adsorption treatment is determined by the type of substance to be removed. Which type of substance you want to remove results your effectiveness of the process. So the substances with a high molecular weight and low water solubility are better absorbed with the active carbon. What are the requirement? The substances with high molecular weight. The molecular weight should be high and low water solubility should be there. Then the active carbon, the result of the active carbon will be better. The concentration of the to be removed substances, the presence of other organic compounds, temperature, pH and the setup design also influence the effectiveness of the adsorption. So along the molecular weight and the solubility, few other factors are also responsible for the better and the good quality of adsorption. Okay, so what are the factors? They are the presence of the other organic compounds in the solution, the temperature of the medium, the pH of the medium, how you set up the design. These are the things which influence the adsorption process. So a realistic load factor for the active carbon vary between 10 to 13%. The load factor for other adsorbents is lower, 1 to 5%. This means a large column and large adsorbent quantities are needed. Okay, so for the good results, you need the large column and the large adsorbent quantities. Means larger amount, higher amount is required for the good results. The results in high investment and operational cost. An advantage of using other adsorbents is that they are more specific and remove other substances than the active carbon. So thank you and hope you are satisfied with this detailed session. If you have any query, please write in the comment box. I will resolve your query. This session is powered by Digital Version 2, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, Jaipur.